Man, you don't even see this in the NFL. You don't even see this in the NFL. We play on Sundays, baby. It's nothing. It's Edison, baby.
Yes, they were that good. During their 5 non-league games, the Chargers scored an astounding 195 points versus 81 by their opponents. Their finest non-league game was against perennial powerhouse Mater Dei, ranked 3rd in the state at the beginning of the season. It was a war that was played out on a battlefield of 50 by 100 yards.
Thank you.
Edison's suffocating defense harassed modern day's quarterback all night long, sacking him 4 times and intercepting him twice. The Sunset League is one of the most competitive in Southern California. Every game is exciting, but no game is as exciting as the crosstown rivalry between Edison and Fountain Valley, known as the Battle for the Bell.
Go Edison!
How are you doing, Matt?
Good. Oh,
wow.
Right there. Oh, Matt.
Great. I'm excited about today. Woo!
Great. All right, well, let me just give you the rundown right here, okay? Now, about 3:30, we're all going to meet up today. We're all going to pregame a little bit. You know, coach is going to give us a little rundown of what's going to happen. Around 5 o'clock, we're going to get on the bus, make our way to our home stadium, OCC, where we do the dirty on pretty much everybody who comes in there. We like to call it the Charger Dome. Around 6:30, we're going to be warming up, and we're going to see the little Barons come in there, trying to think they're going to take our bell away. And about around 7, we're going to kick the ball off.
In the end zone,
so we're not going to get a chance to hit them then. But on the first play, and let me tell you, on the first play, we're going to electrify the Barons. And you heard it first.
All night long.
Suspense.
About 9 o'clock.
Spoken like a true man.
You know, we're going to shake their hands, be gentlemen about it, and then run to the bell and bring it back to this beautiful place.
Four years in a row.
They ain't going to get it.
Luke, but I mean, you know, tonight was kind of like that poem I read, kind of like Luke Gayne, right? I mean, bad things were happening to us. I mean, you know, offense, you know, they had a lot to do with it. You know, they played very well indeed, they did. But we didn't play very well. You know, and when we did have something, you know, then we didn't execute, you know? And you know, maybe I didn't call a very good game, and we just didn't, we were struggling. you know? And the defense kept kind of hanging on, even though, you know, you guys didn't play your best game at time. But you battled, and you're on the field 70% of the time tonight. And you did, you know, you held, and then we turn it over, and Wade dives to that guy. Otherwise, he scores, and we're down 14-0, you know? And maybe we would have folded shop. I hope not, but maybe. And then the defense stops, and he misses a field goal.
You know, he was just struggling, but you know, a sign of a, you know, we have to tell the kids, yeah. You know, it's not, we talked about today before the game, you know, 10% is what happens to you and 90% how you react to it. You know, yeah. We talked about Luke Gayne. I mean, you know, Luke Gayne had something terrible happen to him, but his positive attitude has been uplifting to everybody. It's how you react to tough situations. Matt Viles didn't have a very good game until the end. And then, you know, because he didn't pout, he didn't put it, you know, he didn't quit. He comes back and, you know, if those two touchdown passes to win it, so.
And he was hurting. What was he?
He got drilled a bunch of times tonight.
He did, I know. But he kept on playing.
Kept on playing. That's how he's been. We got some tough kids here. And then we get a little bit of life, and then, you know, I'm gonna go to Coach Justice. I'm almost apologizing to him because we're sucking on offense. Dude, I don't know what play to call anymore. I've tried a little bit of everything and nothing's working. And he goes, shit, try your trick play.
That's what I'm talking about.
And then we execute that, and we all of a sudden we got a little bounce to our step, and then we blocked a little better, and you know, Matt starts getting, you know, we're making catches and we're blocking better. Matt's throwing better. And then, you know, we make some great plays, individual plays. And you know, but it's just a great example.
We ran a sweep right to Davion Orphy. He threw it back to Matt Viles.
Was it just a sweep? It was a sweep pitch?
Sweep pitch.
To
Davion 21. Orphy. 21.
And then back.
And he threw it back to Viles.
Yeah.
And Will Andrew was a tight end on the right side.
Right?
And
he
dives on the ground like he falls down. And then he runs back across the field.
Thank you.
for the fourth straight year.
Play at the varsity level at Edison takes a four-year commitment for most players. Even those seniors who don't play first string still make a valuable contribution to the team's success and ultimately to their own. To those few dedicated young men who made it, we congratulate them and their supporting parents. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.